I did a video on the topic of coming off keto and going back on keto and then not getting results. And someone had a question about metabolic flexibility. So I thought I'd do a video on that one topic. So what is metabolic flexibility? It's your capacity to adapt to different fuels. So you're on low carb, then you can switch on high carb and your body is able to adapt to it and your metabolism is fairly good. Now, the first thing I want to mention is there's very few people that have metabolic flexibility. Most people have metabolic inflexibility. So they start going from high carb to low carb and then high carb to low carb. And every time they do that, they have a harder and harder time of getting in ketosis and adapting. And also what happens when they go back and forth because they're having a cheat day or they can't seem to be consistent, they actually slow their metabolism over a period of time. The question is, how did they become metabolic inflexible in the first place? A history of insulin elevation over time. This little hormone, insulin, is the gatekeeper. It is the main thing that determines what type of fuel you're gonna burn. If the insulin goes up, you're not gonna burn fat, you're gonna burn sugar. If the insulin goes down, you will burn fat. But this hormone gets damaged as you stimulate this hormone over time by consuming a lot of carbs and also by eating frequently, and you start developing insulin resistance. And this is the thing that really is behind a slow metabolism and a stuck set point where no matter what you do, you can't seem to get below a certain weight. And that comes from yo-yo dieting, especially if you're doing a low-calorie, high-carb, low-fat diet, which so many people have done that. Also, stress will ruin this system. Pregnancy puts a lot of stress in that system. And many women who become pregnant and have the baby find that that's the point where their metabolism has slowed down. So this hormone change can really affect this system right here. Lack of sleep. Let's say, for example, you're working third shift for many, many years. That can greatly affect your metabolism. Overtraining. I remember I worked on a patient who was exercising, I'm not kidding, 6 hours a day, okay, 7 days a week. That's overtraining. And she wondered why she couldn't lose weight. There's no chance of recovering from that. Okay, then we have inflammation. If you have inflammation in the body, that can create insulin resistance. So if you're lucky enough not to have to go through a lot of these stressors, you may have metabolic flexibility and you can pretty much get away with going back and forth and back and forth. But if you're like most people and you have metabolic inflexibility, including myself, you're gonna have to try a different approach. You're not gonna be able to get away with the cheat day. You're gonna have to be consistent, consistently keeping the insulin normalized through doing healthy keto, intermittent fasting, exercise consistently, and making sure that your nutrients in the food are at a high level. And it does take some time to really correct this. I'm talking about months, possibly even a few years, because I don't want to give anyone this idea that, hey, in 3 or 4 weeks, your metabolism is going to be corrected and you can go back to your normal foods because now you have a fast metabolism. Now, if you need more information about plateau, I put that video right here. Check it out.